Should I spread my collagen out across my meals? I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. All right, Will Estes asks, I read that bone is about 45% protein and about 99% of that is collagen. I've read close figures. I believe it's 45% protein and 95% collagen based on the last time I read something about it. Will continues, if you're trying to reverse osteopenia, would it make sense to take a small dose of collagen with every meal? I'm interested in the efficacy of taking 3 or 4 doses of collagen spread out through the day instead of a single large dose. My thinking is that it might be like calcium, where you want a small incremental amounts throughout the day to support ongoing bone building activity. Yeah, I totally agree with that. So I'm not sure what the best dosing is, given that it hasn't actually been studied fully. But I believe that it was estimated that in the people who have the highest collagen waste during collagen turnover, that they can run short of glycine about 60 grams a day. Whereas I believe the more conservative estimate of glycine requirements based on people that turn over collagen much more efficiently, which is, I'm not sure exactly what the distribution is, but I believe that because I don't know the distribution, let me say the typical instead of the average or median or whatever. I think the typical person requires about 10 grams of glycine a day based on more efficient collagen than the worst case scenario, which is more like 60 grams. So if the typical person requires about 10 grams of glycine a day, then that would translate to about 30 grams of collagen a day. And then, you know, you might say that the maximal scenario based on the worst case efficiency in terms of losing collagen peptides or losing glycine during collagen turnover might be something more like 180 grams of collagen, but that might be the extreme edge case. And then if you want to evenly distribute it, that through 3 or 4 meals, you know, you divide 30 grams by that, or maybe you provide a margin of error and say, okay, I'm going to try to get 50 grams. Or maybe you shoot for convenience and you say something like there's 15 grams in a tablespoon, 4 meals a day is going to be 45 grams a day. That might be a nice compromise between a convenient dose to divide and the actual math, given all our uncertainty around it. So a tablespoon of collagen at each of 4 meals would provide 45 grams of collagen. And so the rationale here is, and if this is particularly your interest, then part of what would distinguish collagen from taking glycine powder, for example, would be that collagen peptides or just gelatin, when they're digested, are not digested entirely into individual amino acids. They are digested into, I think, di- and tripeptides partly. And these smaller peptides are more efficiently turned into collagen than just the individual amino acids would be. And so you get the benefit of having a precursor closer to what you're actually synthesizing. And yeah, I mean, it's certainly the case that collagen provides the main infrastructure onto which minerals are deposited. And if you're trying to reverse osteopenia or osteoporosis, I would think collagen could be very useful for that purpose. Although I know of no RCTs with collagen supplements actually showing reversal of osteopenia or osteoporosis. But in terms of doing the things that are probably helpful, I would definitely think that that would be one of them. And I totally agree with the rationale that bone synthesis and bone resorption is something that's taking place throughout the entire day. Of course, there might be cycles in it, but it's still going to be an ongoing continuous process. And you're going to want those blood levels of the collagen peptides to be continuously supplying the nutrients needed to the bone. And that's best achieved in spread out doses through the day. And most, I would say that as a general rule, you should assume that you want something spread out as much as possible rather than the reverse if you don't have the data showing that it's okay or better to have it all at once. Because it almost always, wherever there is data or wherever there is a plausible rationale, it's almost always the case that it's better to have it spread out. All right, I hope that answers your question, Will. Thank you very much.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. For the remainder of 2020, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.